Nos tumbaron la iglesia, la primera iglesia nos la tumbaron. Ahorita hay una capillita ahí.
It was on the 15th of September, and the men who were working for us up there expanding the church, they said that somebody had come by on a horse, and they said that the Zaragoza said, "You're not allowed to build this." And they said, "But we're already here. It's like, you know, our church, and we're just expanding our church." And I said, "Oh, you know," I said, "don't worry about it, because the Zaragozas are a Catholic family. Like, they would never touch the church." And sure enough, that night they sent some guys and they just like leveled the church. They took a big chain on the back of a truck and they just pulled the main beam of the church out and knocked it down. Just took about 2 minutes. And on the third day, kind of like in John's gospel, Jesus says, "Destroy this temple and I will rebuild it in 3 days." And 3 days after this happened, we had everybody in the community, both up on the Mesa and down in Anapra, Protestant, Catholic, Jehovah's Witness, kind of no religion. Everybody got together and we rebuilt the basic infrastructure of the chapel in a day, and then kind of had a big meal and a fiesta. While we were rebuilding it that Saturday, one of the guys came from the Zaragoza encampment and he said, "You know, you're not allowed to do this. You're not allowed to build this." And I said, "Well, I said, we've had this land long before you came up here, and all we're doing is expanding the church. It's not a private home or anything like that." So he was looking kind of skeptical, and I said, "I understand this is a land dispute, but," I said, "this is not just land, this is sacred ground, this is holy ground." I said, "If I was you and your boss or anybody, like, I really would never touch this again."
Viene la policía, pero la policía dicen que ellos no pueden hacer nada, que ellos nomás pueden estar mirando que no haya pleito, pero que ellos no pueden intervenir, que porque es propiedad privada. Dice ahí, tienen un letrero ahí en la entrada, a ver si pueden ir, que dice propiedad privada. Pero nosotros decimos, ¿cómo puede ser propiedad privada si está en litigio? O sea, mientras está en litigio, ni ellos ni nosotros somos dueños. Pero nosotros como poseedores tenemos el derecho.
Me dijo, "Véngase, vamos", y nos fuimos. No, me golpearon, me aventaron. Y del golpe que me aventó recio arriba de unos montones de alambre de púa. De ahí me puse bien mala y el mismo viejo le dijo a unas grandototas que traían por...
Cholas, eran como cholas.
Para que nos golpearan, ¿verdad?
Manuel Balderas, who was actually a licensed Mexican lawyer hired by the Zaragozas to oversee the what I would call the vigilante group, and he started walking towards the car and he says, "Matan los pinche perros," like, "kill those effing dogs." So about 40 men descend upon these four local guys. One kid, Pepe, runs away. He gets away. And another man, Luis Guerrero, they start beating him. It was his car, beating him on the front of his car. The day of his funeral, the Zaragozas put a big paid advertisement into the El Diario newspaper, in which they said, we're very sorry about the death of Luis Guerrero. We don't know anything about it. We don't even know what's going on the Mesa. We rent the property to a third party and he's like clearing the land for us. And nobody actually lives up there. It's kind of a rustic piece of land, and the only thing up there is some cactus. And and they said, we have some of our cattle up there, our dairy cows, and that's why we put up the barbed wire fence, so that the dairy cows would not wander off the property.
Y ahí enseguida había una familia que tenía tres niños chiquitos y una niña grande de escuela. Y ese día se llevó a la niña a la escuela y dejó la casa encerrada con los niños adentro. Y según la ronda de los vecinos, vino un trabajador de los hermanos Zaragoza y le roció de gasolina alrededor a la casa y le prendieron, dando los dos niños adentro.
Y
no pudimos hacer nada porque estaba con candado y todo.
Oía los gritos, porque fui el primero que llegó allí. Oí los gritos de los niños, los lloridos, y uy, es feo. Cuando sacaron los niños, así uno pegó el espín. Entonces, el carboncito, y a uno llegando a la puerta.
The police said, oh, there was a wire, a bad wire, and that caused the fire. But a bad wire in the roof of a house wouldn't cause it to burn from the ground up. And this house burned from the ground up. Within like 5-10 minutes, it was completely burnt. The mother, I spoke to her, she said they didn't have electricity, that the cables were not connected.
Ya después pasó el accidente de un jacalito que se quemó acá arriba, donde se quemaron dos niños. Y pues como también yo tengo casa de material, de cartón, de madera, pues a mí sí me dio miedo seguir.
So it really became kind of a war of what is true and what is not true, of people who have unlimited resources against people who have really often just their courage and their sense of resilience and friendship and camaraderie of other people.
Nos quedamos sin nada. A veces mi esposo está pensionado y pues no nos alcanza para todo. Ahora la gasolina, tiene uno que bajar a traer hielo, a traer algo de mandado, pues tiene uno que ocupar la gasolina y no le alcanza el dinero para todo, para comer, para sostener el mueble, para todo eso, pues no le alcanza a uno y batallamos.